Elder Curtis Rainey. I'm excited today about the cause of Jesus being a part of my life. Baptized in Jesus' name, filled with the Holy Ghost, and God has given me a desire and a passion for His Word, for the Word of God. I love studying God's Word. My passion is the Word of God. That's why I invite you to join me in religious studies about the book of Genesis. In this particular study, I found out that Genesis have at least 11 generations, 11 particular points that should be talked about in the book of Genesis. The generation is what is necessary for us to know about Noah. I would like to start saying that in the book of Genesis, the second chapter, verses number 4, it talks about the generation of the heaven and the earth. In Genesis, the fifth chapter, verses number 1 through 5, talks about the generation of Adam. In Genesis, the sixth chapter, verses number 9, this is the subject or the patriarch that I really want to talk about in Genesis is Noah. Noah, Genesis 6 and 9. Now the sons of Noah is in Genesis 10 and 1. Shem, the son of Noah, is 11 and 27. The generation of Ishmael, Genesis 25 and 12. Genesis Isaac, the generation of Isaac, 25 and 19. The generation of Ishmael, 36 and 1. The generation of the sons of Ishmael, Genesis 36 and 9. Genesis 37 and 2 deals with the generation of Jacob. Now, in these generations, I would like to talk about Noah and Noah's generation. In that period of time, that generation was very wicked and violent. And because they were so wicked, that it got the attention of God Almighty. Inasmuch that God told Noah that he would destroy mankind from the face of the earth. And from that particular point of view, God gives Noah a command to build an ark. The ark represents archetypology of Christ being a refuge for the people in crisis time. But the ark represents a refuge for Noah in his generation of time, for the saving of Noah's family. First of all, foremost, when God chooses a man in a generation to do a job, first of all, it's necessary for him to save his family or to save his household. That's his first commitment to God. Save my family first. First, the gospel is preached to the family, and then the gospel spreads out as it did in the book of Acts of the second chapter. Preach it to the Jews first at home. Then preach it to the Samaritans, those people that somewhat are far off. Then preach it to the Gentile people, which were considered afar off from the plan of God. But Christ, as the type of the ark in his time, would be the saving station for the generation that Christ dealt with. In Noah's time, the ark was a saving generation or the refuge place or point for Noah and his family to be saved from the flood. And the flood consisted of water that come from beneath the earth and water that come from the heavens. God opened the windows of heaven and let it rain. Now the people in Noah's time had never seen rain. The earth was watered by the dew that came on the ground by night. Never rained. And they mocked Noah. They ridiculed Noah because they asked questions. What is rain? It's never rained on the face of the earth before. They had no idea what God was about to pour his judgment out. But because God told Noah, and Noah was obedient to God, it took Noah 120 years to build the ark that God had commanded him to. During those 120 years, couldn't you imagine the ridicule and the talking about and the mockery and the slander and the laughing at Noah because Noah was building a boat on dry land which had never rained? But Noah loved God. He was obedient to God's word and he kept building the ark. God told him to pitch the ark within with pitch and without with pitch. The ark specification was it was 450 feet long. The beam of the ark was 75 feet. The depth of the ark was 45 feet. Noah did it exactly like God had commanded him to do. And when this was done, God shut the door in the ark. And God opened the windows of heaven and rain began to fall. When the rain fell on the earth, the waters on the earth began to rise higher and higher every day until the boat or the ark that Noah and his family had entered began to move higher and higher. Then those people that mocked him, ridiculed him, laughed at him during those 120 years started to bang on the door saying, "Noah, Noah, open the door and let us in." Noah said, "God has shut the door and you can't come in." In our time today, God's going to pour the judgment out, but it takes a saving station for mankind to escape the wrath of God. And when mankind come into the safety of the ark or the safety of Jesus Christ, then they can escape the wrath of God. As sure as I'm sitting here now, the words of God that was uttered, that was talked about, that was proclaimed in Noah's time, in the sixth chapter of the book of Genesis, or the sixth generation of Noah, God did bring it to pass. Just because it didn't rain that next day, just because it took 120 years later, God was faithful about his word. What God said, he will do it. God's word is fixed. Before one jot or tittle of God's word fail, God will destroy heaven and earth. So we can stand assured that God will do exactly what he said he would do. And because Noah was obedient to God's word, he saved his house. Shem was one of the sons of Noah that was saved in the ark. Japheth was one of the sons that was saved in the ark. Ham was one of the sons that was saved in the ark because of their obedience to their father. And their father loved God, and God saved his house because of his obedience towards God. We have to be obedient to God's word today. As though God has set judgment upon the world at a particular time to come, they asked the Lord, "When will you pour your judgment out upon the world?" Jesus says in one particular passage in the book of Matthew, the 25th chapter, thereabout he talks about when the time of the Gentiles be come in, then the wrath of God will be poured out upon mankind. But it's necessary for us today to be found in safety in Jesus Christ. It's necessary for us today to find refuge in Christ Jesus in order to escape the judgment of God or the wrath of God being poured out upon the world.